Hello friends, and welcome to the unboxing and configuration video of the DVR F1104 4-channel DVR. The device is compatible with D-Link's mobile application, which helps you monitor the inputs from all the CCTV cameras that are connected to the device. You can find a list of all the other features. So the videos are saved in H.264 compression. It supports HDMI, HD input, and USB backup. So let's just have a look at the contents of the box. So once you open the box, you'll find the DVR unit itself. So behind the device, you'll find all the ports. So these are the video ports where your camera's output will be connected. So this is a VGA port where you can connect your display, or alternatively you can use the HDMI port, which will definitely give you a better output. And these are the audio ports where you can connect the audio outputs of your CCTV cameras. This is the Ethernet port, and these are the USB ports. So let's check out what else we get in the box. So this is the quick installation guide and CD. Apart from that, you'll find another box in which you'll find the mouse, which you can connect to the device, use to scroll through. And this is the power adapter and some connectors and screws. So this is the camera we'll be using to test our DVR. The model number is DCS F1712. It is a full HD camera. It supports the IP66 feature, which makes it dustproof and water resistant. It also supports other features like 30 meter infrared range, a day and night feature, full HD output, and other features. So you'll find some of the other key features listed on the side here. So let's open the box. So once you open the box, you'll find the manual of the camera and the camera itself. This is a very sturdy outdoor camera with IP66 rating, so it is resistant to dust and heavy jets of water. So these are the audio and video cable, and we also have the power cable. So let's start with the connections. So we have the DVR and we have the camera. So let's start by making the connections. So first I take the power adapter and insert it into the power port right here. So currently I'm using an external power adapter, and I'll use this port to connect my camera to the DVR. So this is basically a BNC connector. And you connect the male to the female. This is how you connect. So the other end of this connector will be connected to one of the video inputs of your DVR. So next, I'll connect the VGA cable of our monitor to our VGA port, which is right here. So alternatively, you can also connect the HDMI port, but currently I'm using the VGA. So right now we have connected one camera to one of these ports. We can similarly use all these other ports to connect total four cameras. Since this is a 4-channel DVR, we can connect four cameras. This is where we have connected our monitor. You can also use the HDMI port that is located below that. These are the audio inputs where you can connect the microphone outputs of your CCTV cameras. This is the Ethernet cable, which you can use to connect your DVR to the internet if you wish to do so. And below that, you will find the USB cables, which you can use to take backup of your recordings. So on the other side of the device, you will find a QR code. So what this does is basically helps you to access your DVR across the internet. What you have to do is you just have to scan the code and your DVR will be connected to the cloud. So once you power your device on, you'll see the power LED being lit. The second LED is the alarm LED, which will be lit if there is any motion detection. The third LED will be lit if the DVR is recording video. And this LED will be lit if the DVR is connected to the internet. And here is a USB port which you can use to connect your mouse. So once your device boots up, you'll be prompted with this screen where a default user called admin will be created. So the default password for this user is admin123. So you have to enter that and click OK. So as you can see, we have gone ahead and connected three more cameras to our device, and you can see the output from all the four cameras simultaneously. And if you can observe this red dot in the corner, that means that the output from all these cameras is being recorded to the hard drive of the DVR. So if you want to focus on any one camera, you can just click on it and it will be maximized. And you can also use the scroll button on your mouse to zoom in and zoom out. So it's very simple to operate. So if you want to play back any recording that has been done in the past, you can scroll down on the screen and you can find out an option called as time search. So once you click on it, this is what you'll see. So let's say you have to access the footage recorded on a specific day. So you can just click on the date. And once you click on the date, you'll find the timeline of that particular day. So you just can scroll through the timeline and find out the part of the footage that you're interested in. And if you want to focus on any specific camera, you can select the camera in the left pane here. And you can see the footage from that specific camera. You can also expand it to fit the screen. So it's pretty straightforward and easy to operate. So our DVR is now connected to an active internet connection. How we have done that is by connecting it to a router through the Ethernet cable. So there is a good way to check that. What you do is you right click anywhere on the screen. And once this menu appears, you go to the system settings and in the network section, where you will see the IP address being obtained. So you can go down and open the check tab, and all these options have to be ticked. That means you're connected to an active internet connection. Click OK. So now we'll see how to access your DVR from the D-Link CCTV mobile application. It is a powerful application available for iOS and Android devices, which gives you extreme portability. So to do that, you can right click and go to the system settings. So once you go there and in the app section, you'll find three different QR codes. The top two are to actually install the application on your device. So you can scan the iOS QR code on your iOS device and it will direct you to the app store. You can do the same with Android if you have an Android device. And the QR code at the bottom is something that you'll scan through your app to connect to the DVR. So once you have installed your app, you have to open it and open the menu and go into the device section. So here you have to add a new device. You can enter a name for your device. And then you'll be prompted to this screen where you are asked to scan the QR code. So after you are done with that, you'll have to enter the password of your device which you set earlier. We set it to admin123. And then we save our device, and immediately you'll get access to the previews of all the four cameras which are connected to your DVR. So that is how you set up the D-Link 4-channel DVR.